ready to match the star. Robert Vaughn, Brett Summers, Gary Berghoff, Patty Duke-Aston, Richard Dawson, and Missy McCall as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's your star of Match Game 75, Gene Rivers.
I welcome you one and all. Listen, I didn't ask you about the Towering Inferno. That's already going, and is it as wild as a previous one that producer did, the Poseidon thing?
I think it's twice as wild.
Yeah, it's got, yeah. I mean, the special effects.
Yeah.
It's something to see, I guess.
They have a fantastic.
What's that?
They have a fantastic.
Fantastic
line of actors in that. They're shooting that right across from MASH. MASH,
yes.
Tuesday
Oh, yeah,
night.
MASH on CBS. That's right. Tuesday nights at 8. Thank you. That's right. All right, get it out of your system, everybody.
Hi, gang.
About that on Masquerade Party the other night.
Well, when we open with Van Margaret in Florida.
All right, that's enough of that. I thank you for that. Now let's say hello to our current champion, Betty Kubota, there. Hello, Betty. How are you? Good. Betty just won a game. Well, the time ran out last time, right? You've got your $100. Now you're going to have to go at the Big Money Super Match where you can win over $5,000. Are you ready for that?
Yes.
Okay, we're ready for you. Well, not quite ready for you. 1 minute, and then we'll be ready for her. Now, this lady is going to have a go at the Big Money Super Match. Betty Kubota, you ready?
Yes.
Okay, here we go. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. 16 blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500, but you got to match it. If you match the next one, you get $250. And the third, 100. Okay. Three celebrities are permitted to help. Whom do you choose?
Richard.
16 tons.
16 tons, the old Ernie Ford song.
Mitzi,
have you got one?
16 years old.
16 years old. All
Second.
Right.
And Brett.
No.
And Brett. Have you got one? It's hard to do it when you're in the third position, but...
What about 16? Was it trombones?
16? No.
Reduced.
It's 76. What the balance in your checkbook must look
like. That's right.
I don't believe it's a religious thing with me. I don't believe it.
You sure are steeped in show business, aren't you? 76 trombones.
Such of Americana.
16 trombones.
Well, it's been reduced to 16.
Now listen, now stop fooling around. Have you got one? This lady is asking.
No, then that's it.
So that's your answer, 16 trombones? Wait a minute, did he give you one?
Did you give me one? And never been kissed?
Oh. 16.
And never been kissed.
No, that goes the other way.
That's sweet in there.
That sweet 16 and never been kissed, that wouldn't work here. No,
well,
we've got to take
what she had.
Your first answer, 16 trombones. And I know you're ashamed of it, but we want the whole world to see it.
There,
that's it. There, it says right next to Brett. It says 16 trombones. Oh, boy.
76.
No, you got 16 trombones, 16 tons, and 16 years old. Do you want one of those, or have you got a better one, Betty?
I'll go with Richard. 16 tons.
16 tons. Okay. That was the old Ernie Ford song. That was a very big hit in its day, wasn't it? It's a marvelous old piece. All right, we're looking for 16 tons. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. Here is the $100 response. 16 going on 17.
That's that song. I am 16 going on 17.
Richard Rodgers will never hire you,
Mitzi.
Now we're looking for 16 tons. Here's the $250 response. 16 candles.
Have you ever heard of such awful answers?
Did you think of that?
Uh-huh.
Yes.
16 candles, is it a big hit?
Well, way back when.
Oh, I see. But not as old as 16 tons.
No.
Right, okay. Last chance for 16 tons. Here we go with a $500 response. 16 tons, you got it. Good. Congratulations to you, Betty. How is it kissing him with the beard?
Fuzzy.
Fuzzy? Was he fuzzy?
He was fuzzy.
He was fuzzy. Was he fuzzy? Yes, he was fuzzy. Was he fuzzy? Okay, now you're going to play for $5,000. But before we can give you that amount of money, you must match one of those ding-a-lings head-to-head. Must be exact. Which one will it be?
Richard.
Okay. In spite of the fact that he's fuzzy, you choose him again, eh? All right, Fuzzy. Would you write your answer to this, if you please? David and blank. David and blank. All right, Richard is finished with his answer. Now, Betty, we ask you for your response, which you think will match his. How do you fill that blank in? David and...
Goliath.
You say David and Goliath. Well, the audience agrees with you. We're going to find out if you're right right now. Richard, for $5,000, may we see your response?
I saw a film the other night called David and Lisa.
David and Lisa.
Then I wrote the line.
Oh!
Terrific.
Money makes you feel terrific, huh? What are you going to do with all that loot?
Oh, I have to buy my son a new blanket.
Well, that's right. Listen, Mark. See, get a shot of this somewhere. This is a part of her son's security blanket. Isn't that something? And she's been squeezing it and pulling it apart and doing all that thing. Well, it brought you luck. You've got $5,600. You're going to meet another player right now. So let's welcome Carolina Fraley. Betty Cavada, don't you?
I'm so excited for her.
Isn't it great?
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Now, where are you from?
I'm from Long Beach, and I've been a teacher for 7 years.
Yes, what do you teach?
I used to teach sixth grade in La Fuente and music. I love to sing.
Yeah.
But now I'm a very happy wife.
Yes.
And a mother of a six-month-old baby boy and a homemaker.
Oh, that's good. You married one of your students, did you?
No. Oh, no. He is younger than I am.
Oh. Well, good luck to you here. And
thank you.
I hope we get a chance to hear you sing somewhere along the line.
Oh.
We're
going
to start this game in a moment or so, but first we got to start this message for you. Right, now we're ready to start. Carolita, you seem to be ready. Are you pulled together there?
Yes.
Okay, please make a selection, Carolita.
I'm going to choose A for accurate.
A for what?
Accurate.
Oh, A for accurate. Oh. Well, we'll find out how that works out.
You can take the teacher out of the schoolroom, but...
Yeah. Richard Dawson said...
Oh, dear.
He said, I really made a fool of myself at the drive-in restaurant. Mm-hmm. When the gorgeous car hop asked me what I wanted... I took one look at her, and instead of saying, bring me an order of fries, I said, bring me an order of blanks. I took one look at her, instead of saying, bring me an order of fries, I said, bring me an order of blanks.
What was the first part of the question?
He said, I really made a fool of myself at the drive-in restaurant.
You should have seen him in the dressing room.
When the gorgeous car hop asked me what I wanted, I took one look at her, instead of saying, bring me an order of fries, I said, bring me an order of...
I bet you did do that, too. Right.
Okay, we can put it inside there, we know where you're at. All right, did you finish, sir? All right. Okay, now we come to Carolita here. Richard Dawson said, I really made a fool of myself at the drive-in restaurant. When the gorgeous car hop asked me what I wanted, I took one look at her. Instead of saying, bring me an order of fries, I said, bring me an order of...
And did you say blanks?
Of blanks, yes.
It has to be boobs.
It does? Did you hear that, sixth grade? All you sixth graders out there. Sixth graders of the world, unite. You have nothing to lose but your... Okay. Let's see now. You're playing, aren't you? Everybody plays, because it's a first-round question. What did you say? She said, bring me an order of...
I didn't have the blank to say what she said, so I said eyes.
Bring me... Instead of bring me an order of fries, I said, bring me an order of eyes. That's not bad. Don't boo him. He's a star. Remember that. Why?
I do believe this is a match.
Let's see what it says.
I said, bring me an order of buns.
Yeah.
No. Matt.
No, 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 no. Boobs and buns are not interchangeable. No. What did you say?
I'm as embarrassed as you are. I said boobs.
Okay, there's one for you, Carolita. What are you offering?
Well,
we need one more for a pair.
Richard would go for the whole thing, so I said that he would say an order of you, my darling lovely.
Yes, he would say that. Wouldn't you say that, Richard?
No, I wouldn't.
Oh.
No. Well, I like to keep abreast of the times. Oh. So I would say
Well, I'm glad we finally got a pair. Now you.
Well, I, of course, said boobs.
Oh. Well, okay.
But wait a second, Gene.
What?
He ordered them, but he ordered them sunny side up.
Oh, I see. So that's three for you. Now, this is your first round question. The 102-year-old man said...
Start over.
He said...
When is Charles coming back?
I'd like to start a special Boy Scout troop for old people. And our troop will give out merit badges for blanking. 2 years old.
You wanted to start a Girl Scout troop?
No Boy Scout troop for old people. He says, and our troop will give out merit badges for blanking.
I got it, sweetheart.
Are you ready? Ready? Ready?
Okay. I'm ready, honey.
I'll run over here now, and I'll get an answer from her.
I love it when you tap dance like that.
Hello there.
Hi.
I'd like to start a special Boy Scout troop for old people, and our troop will give out merit badges for blanking.
Making love.
Really?
At that age.
102 years old?
At that age.
Hey, you'd need a medal if you... Okay. She says she'd give out merit badges for making love.
What
the implication
thought.
Is if you could, you know, if you could, you'd need, yeah. you deserve the medal.
You could. You should right. when you're there.
You should, okay. Do you say you should?
Well, no. I say 102, you got a merit badge for living.
Just for living, that's it. Just for making it from one day to another there. Okay, Brett.
I understand in England at 102 they give you the Victoria Cross.
That's true.
No, I said just for moving.
For moving. Okay. All right, so we got living and moving, Gary.
Oh, I don't know if... I don't know if this is... a match or not, I
I'll
meant
be the
it
judge
in the same
that.
Sense, young lady.
Yes, what? And
I meant really, really, really living.
No.
That's a match.
That ain't making love.
Tried.
Okay. Now, how about you?
I thought...
New kid on the block?
Yeah. I thought that, that for just being alive, you
breathing.
Should get a super breathing.
Good answer. Yeah. Breathing. Loser, but good.
Loser,
yes.
But nice.
Okay.
They're all good answers. They're all losers. Attempts at loving.
Okay. What about it, Mitzi?
Well, in the home I come from, excuse me, in the home I come from, see, if you make love, you do something right after. Fainting.
Fainting. Makes you dizzy, doesn't it? Okay.
Oh, crazy.
So it's 3-1 and a round one. Our challenger's ahead, and now this. So hurry back. Now, here we go with round two, ladies. Are you ready? Okay. Carolita, please make a selection.
I will choose A again.
A again? All right. Last time you matched three of our celebrities, Gary, Richard, and Mitzi. The three of you do not play. The rest do. I have a little limerick for the rest of you.
Uh-oh.
And it goes like this. A little old old, long-bearded gnome makes a Hollywood car wash his home. He kisses each car that belongs to a star, so his lips are all covered with blank. He kisses each car that belongs to a star, so his lips are all covered with... All right, you may put that...
You have to do it.
A little old long-bearded gnome makes a Hollywood car wash his home. He kisses each car that belongs to a star, so his lips are all covered with blank.
Is there an answer?
There is an answer! And it's so easy...
Okay. I wouldn't even give her that much of a clue. She doesn't deserve it.
Okay, she's finished. Yes, indeed, I will say it again for you, Carolita, because she's finished now. And here we go. A little old long-bearded gnome makes a Hollywood car wash his home. He kisses each car that belongs to a star, so his lips are all covered with...
Snow.
Well...
Rhyme, or is
it's supposed
a
to be a limerick. You see, it's home and gnome.
Dome.
Sorry.
Yeah.
Too late. The rule is we've got to accept your first answer, so we'll have to do that. And snow is about as rotten an answer as you're going to get here.
Worse one coming up.
Watch for a worse answer than snow coming up right now. Ta-da-da.
I rhymed the wrong word and said tar.
Tar. You're right. That's worse than hers. Okay.
That's frightening. He's making motion pictures.
That's right. Yes, Brett.
I was going to say stardust.
Yes.
But then I figured that that was not as good a rhyme as foam.
Foam is good. That's good. You done good.
That's what our teacher would say.
Right. What did you say?
I say that I'm not playing this game.
You're not playing?
Nope.
Oh, that's right. Three do not play. Oh, you're the only other one we call on here. What have you got?
I said foam.
Foam
seems to be the answer.
Foam or chrome? Chrome would have worked.
Chrome would have been good.
Well, chrome, you know, the radiator, a lot of chrome parts and all that.
I just went blank.
You went drew a blank.
I was too excited.
Now, at this moment, you're ahead 3-1. You need 2 to tie, 3 to win, okay? Here we go. Who does not play? Richard. There's a new Walt Disney movie called Minnie Mouse Meets Willard the Rat. At the end of the movie, Minnie gets blank.
Could you do that again, Doctor?
Yeah. The new Walt Disney movie is called Minnie Mouse Meets Willard the Rat. Yes. At the end of the movie, Minnie gets blank. It's up to you to put something in that blank. And Betty will give us an answer in a moment or so, trying to match you. Okay. We don't need the artwork. Just give us the answer there, Gary.
What do you mean you don't need the artwork?
Well,
I just put the card in there.
Okay, put it in a slot there,
and away we go.
Over here to Betty Cabada. The new Walt Disney movie is called Minnie Mouse Meets Willard the Rat. You've seen Walt Disney movies, haven't you? At the end of this movie, Minnie gets...
Made love to?
Minnie gets made love to. You don't say it that way in my country, but what the heck? Minnie gets made love to.
Try snow.
All right, that's an answer. Says Minnie gets made love to.
Not in a Walt Disney movie.
No.
I don't know. Married.
Minnie gets married.
Walt Disney movie.
Yes.
Minnie gets married and married and married and married and
you shut up!
I understand. Is there someone to my left?
Yes, there is.
I understand you speak many tongues. Do you not?
Yes.
Now, do you know what that word is?
Enceinte.
Very good. Or pregnant.
Or pregnant.
We like to educate as we go along. Don't we, Jim?
No match there. Okay. All right.
Oh,
Judges believe in immaculate conception, huh?
How did I get pregnant?
Well, it's possible, you see.
There must be a star over the farmer's market.
No.
I can't believe that.
Because someone gave Minnie Mouse a pill, and that's...
Sure.
All right, Gary.
There's a full moon over the farmer's market. No, obviously nobody up here has seen Willard. I went the other way. I said Eaton.
Eaton, okay. Well, you got a match of two remaining ones, Betty, to stay in the game. She says Minnie, at the end of the movie, Minnie gets made love to.
Well, she did, then she got, you know...
Oh, pregnant, yeah.
A little cute maternity clothes.
That is not a match, and that means that Carolita Fraley wins the game.
Thank you.
questions, Carolita. You stand by for a moment or so. And I'll say goodbye to pretty Betty Kubota here. Listen, you're not leaving any. You went all the way with that last game, didn't you? And you got $5,600. Thank you very much, Betty Kubota. Okay. Now, she goes, you hang on to me, and we'll do this message, and then we'll get you some Kleenex.
We've got to stop right here now, and Carolita will be back next time to have a go at the big money. And all of you will be back next time. And remember, you must obey orders. If you do not come back, something terrible will happen to you. And I'll tell you what is going to happen. Hey, listen, I meant to ask you, Gare, is your show still as hot as it's always been? I know it's as funny as it's always been because I watch it all the time. MASH, are you
We're doing terrifically. Yeah, we're in the top five.
Isn't that great?
And
you deserve it. Don't they?
That's in Guam.
All right. Well, that's all the time we've got today. We hope you'll join us next time for Match Game 75. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 75, a Mark Goodson, Bill Tubman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of the CBS stations.